Hello friends, today we are going to see a problem on whole zero representations. So now let us take a difference equation as y of n plus 3 by 4 y of n minus 1 plus 1 by 8 y of n minus 2 equals to x of n plus x of n minus 1. So here we have this problem as we have y of n, 3 by 4 is the coefficient of y of n minus 1, then we have 1 by 8 coefficient of y of n minus 2, then we have inputs x of n and x of n minus 1. So we have seen that the output, okay, we can write the same equation as y of n equals to, I can represent first inputs minus, when I get this on the other side it becomes minus 3 by 4 y of n minus 1 minus 1 by 8 y of n minus 2. So what does this difference equation shows that the present output depends on present input, past input, past output delayed by twice. So we have the present output depends on outputs that are previously occurred and the input and the previous inputs. Okay, so the output depends on so many parameters over here. Now to go ahead, I will use this equation number 1, and our step 1 for our solution will be applying Z transform to equation number 1. So the first step says that you have to apply Z transform on the given difference equation. So yn should be replaced by yz's, coefficients as it is. Now y of n minus 1 will be replaced by z raised to minus 1 y of z plus 1 by 8 y of n minus 2 will be replaced by z raised to minus 2 y of z equals to, okay, x of n will be replaced by x of z plus x of n minus 1 will be replaced as z raised to minus 1 x of z. So this is my new equation, that is step 1. Let us rearrange. So rearranging the previous equations, I pull out y of z common out, then I get 1 plus 3 by 4 z inverse plus 1 by 8 z raised to minus 2 equals to, I pull out x of z common out from here, I get 1 plus z inverse. Okay, then step 2 is obtaining the transfer function. So transfer function h of z is given as output y of z upon input x of z. Okay, so what is output y of z upon x of z according to the equation? We'll get y of z by x of z, which is all equal to h of z, will be equal to, I'll keep the numerator as it is, this term will go to numerator and this term will come to denominator, it will go 1 plus 3 by 4 z inverse plus 1 by 8 z raised to minus 2. Here again we can see that there are numerator and the denominator polynomial. Numerator is with degree 1 and denominator with degree 2. So denominator polynomial will have two roots, whereas the numerator polynomial will have only one root. Now it is difficult to, we have the equation in z raised to minus 2 terms. So let us represent everything in terms of positive powers of z. To do that, Let us add one more step, that is step 3 probably. This step might be included, might be excluded also. Multiply and divide by z raised to minus 2. So I will multiply and divide by z raised to minus 2, let's say this as by 2 equation 2. So I'm performing addition and multiplication on equation number 2. So that gives me h of z as z square plus z divided by z square plus 3 by 4 z plus 1 by 8 z raised to 0. Okay, because here we were having z raised to minus 2, and when we multiply by z raised to plus 2, that gives you z raised to 0. Here I have z raised to minus 1 multiplied by z raised to 2 will give me z raised to 1. This will give me z raised to 0 into z raised to 2 will give me z square. Numerator will give me z square and z. Now I will rewrite this equation, z square plus z divided by z square plus 3 by 4 z plus 1 by 8, because z raised to 0 is 1. Now to find the roots, what I'll do is I will write the numerator part like this, z into z plus 1 by taking out z common. Here the roots will come as z plus 1 by 2 and z plus 1 by 4. So if you solve the denominator equation, you will get the root as z plus 1 by 2 and z plus 1 by 4. Therefore, I can say that the zeros of h of z are, so we have z equals to 0 and z equals to minus 1. And the poles of h of z are, okay, I write p equals to minus 1 by 2 comma minus 1 by 4. Just by equating the terms of the numerator to 0 and equating the terms of denominator equal to 0, we get the zeros and poles of h of z. Now to represent this, or to show how a pole and zero looks like, I will draw a circle with this as my real part of z and this becomes my imaginary part of z. This value is r equals to 1, right? So the radius of this circle is 1, so this becomes 1 and this becomes minus 1 on the real axis, whereas this becomes a j and this becomes minus j, where j is equal to root of minus 1, a complex number. Now to plot 0 at 0 is equal to, to plot a 0 at 0, we have to show a circle on the origin, because this is at 0, z is equal to 0. Then we have at z is equal to minus 1, this is z is equal to minus 1, so here we have one more 0. So if you notice, I have drawn two circles. I will draw with other color, I will fill up with other color. This is my blue colored curves or the two zeros in the system. And let us draw the poles of the system. They will look like, now one pole is at minus 1 by 2 and the second pole is at minus 1 by 4. So negative side is on this side, they are also real. Minus 1 by 2 is 0.5. So minus 0.5 will be represented like this. This is minus 0.5. And I have minus 0.25, which will come over here, minus 0.25. So the red colored cross are called as poles and the blue colored circles are called as zeros. So whenever I draw a zero or I wanted to represent a zero, I will show a circle in the z plane. And whenever I wanted to show a pole, then I will show a cross mark on the z plane. Now here both the poles and zeros are real, and hence we have plotted them on y axis. It might happen that a pole or a zero might be a complex number. So it might come on anywhere in the, on the z plane. So it might not be always on the x-axis or always on the y-axis, but anywhere in between x and y-axis. Thank you.